Which one is the best? Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Today I'm talking about neuromodulators or Botox-like drugs. Which one is the best? There's many factors to talk about to say which one is actually the best, but for people who are getting the procedure done, for them, longevity and safety are probably the two most important things that they think about. Longevity is related to dose. It's one of the things we know, and there was a recent study done measuring the active product in all of the products that we have on the market today, except the newest one, which is Jeuveau. So what came of that study? Well, we know there's Xeomin, Botox, Dysport, and now Jeuveau. So there's four. There's a fifth one we think is gonna come to the market, which likely will have a 6-month indication sometime in 2020. Because of that, we've talked about longevity over the past year, and you've seen videos on high dose Botox or high dose Dysport that I've had on myself and my patients, and we looked at longevity. The more toxin or active product measured in nanograms in the product, theoretically then it should last longer, and we're seeing an element of that. So which one had the most product? Okay, Xeomin had the least at 0.08 nanograms. Then it came up to Botox, and that at its 20 unit study dose had 0.18 nanograms of product, and then Dysport came in the highest at 0.27. So it had 50% more product than its Botox counterpart. Jeuveau, as I said, it wasn't in the study, so we don't know. But the end result of this has shown us that we know Dysport seems to kick in nicely. It has great longevity, and people really like the effect of it. And it might come down to this dosing, that it in fact has the most amount of active ingredient of all the neuromodulators. Two things to talk about is they are all different, and physicians or practitioners who use them, they know the nuances and typically adjust for them. So in a good practitioner, experienced practitioner's hands, they can account for these and add some or take some away. And the next is spread of effect. And so a lot of people think that some spread more than others, particularly Dysport. But if you look at it, it might explain this now, because the higher dose, you're gonna get more spread. It just makes sense. Other factors account for this as well. Speed of injection. The faster you inject something, the more it's gonna wanna spread. And also volume. So people, they're all diluted with water, a type of water, or sterile bacteriostatic. And when we inject more water, you're gonna get more spread. So it's not the complete story, but I obviously can account, if people inject these for a long time, they can account for spread. They stay a little higher with some, lower some, and they add a little higher dose with yet other products to account for these nuances. But it was clear out of the study, the most product was in Dysport for its FDA approved dosing. So there you have it. There's no one best, but the one with the most product came out clearly as Dysport. So thanks for joining me today. Let us know, what are you using? What do you like to use, and how do you use it, in the comments below? Also go over on our Instagram channel, and we talk about these things over there, and there's great discussion. So join us over there to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.